Hello everyone again. Thank you very much for being here again. So today, or yesterday, I was introducing a little bit an overview about what is the main idea of argumentation, about this structure, the different steps that we can define in this process, and how they can be addressed with the current tools that we have in many natural language processes. Talking about anything that they brought sense, analysis, parsing, organizations, and anything with the connection. The idea is to emphasize that undermining is a new field, and most of the things have to be done. There is, as far as I'm aware, there is anything in the literature that we can apply directly and say, do argument. But there are some things. But as far as I know, there is not a really pure technique or with comparable results, such as, for instance, you can get in some of the and tools that you can get the over 95% of positioning syntactic analysis for example. So we started with that yesterday with this overview to frame the points or the gaps we can contribute to develop or to get some ideas of the hypothesis that might have about target mining. Them. After that, I propose or try to argue to defend that R is a good language programming for this task based on two main reasons. The first one is easy from my experience and from people that don't know. The researcher that doesn't have a background in computer science may be quite confident. And it's easy to learn how. And this is my case, personal experience. As I told my background is in philosophy, I'm getting into computer science, I started to do some things with management, and I found R easy to learn and easy to implement small things or the things that I can try and test in an easy way. I tried Java before. Was okay for me. I know that the internet can do Java much more than that, but the balance between time that I need to get a result in R and Java is much easier for me. So after saying that and saying, well, there are some things in R, but pretty much everything that you might do here would be a huge contribution, because there are things here. I introduce an overview of R, the different types, and how I understand or how I address the problems to solve to research. Thinking on them, not from the theoretical perspective, how can I implement this in R? I follow this structure that I was quite new. We have a world test, R is our table, we have text that we want to analyze, we have to decide the data type that we can use to get the result, depending on that, we will have to apply some of the functions or others because they have different inputs, they require different inputs and different data. So you have to you have to be aware about this. We talk about the types because about some basic programming structures that we apply, we will argument with or those conditions how to get the function of the bringing a file or bringing the keyboard, And we stop, well, I stop. In the last part of, only the last part of the timeline that I showed you at the beginning was, well, I have the data, I did some calculation, obtained some results, I'm going to deliver them. Maybe for writing a paper, showing a demo, convince another researcher saying this is really cool. So we need to find a way to show the results in an understandable and nice way. R is really good in that. Producing graphics in R, nice visualization, is not a difficult task. I mean, it might be difficult if you want to do a lot of pretty things. You need to be aware about a lot of parameters, but to get some basic results and plot a graph is really easy. So today I'm going to start an overview of graphics, some the different options that I have, how to optimize them. I'm going to speak also about Shiny, that is a web server version for that, where you can create dynamic graphs. So the user can change the values and the graph, the output that you have, that might be a table, doesn't have to be a graph, might be updated dynamically according to the rhythms of the different requests of the user. So this is also nice for delivering the results. After that, I'm going to go for some references that I use for this slide. So I found interesting of this particular and the themes. And after that, I'm going to show you some examples. If you have R installed, you can play as well. The text is more the themes to show you how you can implement that in R. And in my opinion, that is quite easy to do. You don't need to do many lines of code, be aware of complex structures, to get decent results. If you have any questions from yesterday, please ask whenever you want. Just please interrupt me. Make this too painful. Well, graphics. Something like this can be done in R. So here, this is a kind of Europe representation. You can, it's a bit intricate, but it's follow the structure of the continent. Usually, I don't remember, I took the example from the page. But you can array this. It is a nice graph. So here, this looks like Spain. It reminds to France. Yes. Can you see that? So it's a nice way to graph. This is also for geography. It's quite common to plot images and maps and mountains and ecological situations as well. There are several functions that are already implemented in R and can get the high results. The most common one are plot. Plot is to get a graph to be a point or line depending on the parameter that you have. Bar plot, you have the bars showing the results. Box plot, this is quite interesting. So with R, there are already implemented some statistical measures that is mean, standard deviation, and all of them. You don't have to calculate them manually, you just the function in R already have its name. There are another one that is something like, resume or something like that. So there is one, I can't remember the name now, where you get all of these information, what they mean, standard deviation, just in one function. So it's really easy to get. And this is a way where you can plot all this information in a graph in just one line. And also histogram is already implemented in so, as you can see, there are a lot of functions of the app that make your life easier when you want to show results of your analysis. With plot, which is the basic one, you have the input, the x, right? Here you are going to just a plot. This is by default. Here, ideas, you can change the parameters, just customize the graphs as much as you want. Here you have several values. You can draw a line, basically. Here you have the function, you can evaluate the x value from 1 to 10, and 0 to 1 digits. So we plot the function, it's for the function. And here select the tab that is aligned. And we should hear the label of the y as. And it's done. You don't need anything else. The amount of effort that you have to put here to get this is a fault. This is, it's not something that you can do. Something important that you have to be aware of, as I mentioned, this is generated using the same function. Any idea why? Why using exactly the same plot, just here one value, the data type that you want, to show the graphs, you can get this, or this. Why? Depending on the data that you have, vector, list, data frame, the output could be different. So, as I told you yesterday, I emphasize, be aware about the data types that you are handling, because depending on that, the output of the function might be different. So, to get something like this, and a simple graph, x, y, any idea, do you have any idea what you can do to get that? It's not difficult.
What's the vectors of choice?
When you have another frame,
this is happening.
You can select the values, the components of the data frame that you plot. So instead of using the whole data frame, instead of plotting the whole data frame, you are plotting one of the elements, you can get a whole. So this also means that sometimes you don't need to transform one data, one data type into another to get the result that you want. You just need to select the information that you want to show. This is something that I think is important to keep in the back of your mind when you are doing this. So, given the different of the complexity, the sum of the data types, and you can manage and move all of them sometimes to get the result that you need, it's just a matter of selecting the right information at the right moment. The right information that you already have. Rather than transforming, extracting, you don't need to. Have this data frame now. I need to extract the values of solar radiation. I have to copy them in a vector and after that plotting the vector. Now, if the data frame, one of the components is solar radiation, and you know that, you can plot the type. Okay? So, customizing is all the things that you can change in that. You can have labels, legends, architectural features, but there are a bunch of things that you're not going to know. So the complexity here is not in the generation of the graph, it's rather than how much creative you want to do. Things that you want to show, to change colors, and making graphics, all of this could be make the function more complex. But it's just a matter of visualization, but most of the times rather than a matter of, I mean, thinking about how to transform the The other function that they call is already implemented is histogram. So you can do different ways, but just what writing is. This is one of the default datasets that are now, the air passengers in the 50s. So here, just in plot, the top. Here is not perfect, but it's good enough. The amount of effort that you need to get that. This vision, the result is quite good. This is one of the all the possible combinations that I told you. In customizing a graph, you can change the point by cross line, showing this subset, and a layer, oh sorry, this information in the beginning of the lines, this in here. And the median, labeling the axis. So there is a bunch of information that you can add on. The other nice thing that is a web application framework for R. This axis is defined in R Studio. Do you know R Studio? There's an IDE of RAM, free, and you will also the shadow. It's quite easy to use, and the result is powerful. As I told you, in the main novelty of shadow, you can do activity. You can play with different data, the user can play, and get the results at the same moment. You don't have to change your code. Obtaining things that you might be able to get these results. Provide a bunch of options, then the user can choose the file. So, in the web page, so, for Shiny. So you can find a lot of information on Shiny, tutorials, examples. This is one of the maps where you are changing the options. So this is the interactivity that I can use. So changing the parameters of the graph, the plot that we have is taking a particular user demands. So how difficult or easy is to get that? Not really, the more difficult part is to get the data and do the analysis and the visualization, changing. you have to get you have to create a new file, which is app. It has to be connected to code. And this file has two parts. One is the interface, which is the interface, and the other one is the functions. So the idea is in the user interface is the image is everything, the web that the user is seeing. He's seeing the position, where is the graph in the screen, where are the questions, the type of the buttons that the user can find. And the functions are the elements that you put in that boxes. So the color of the graph is what do you have to change the color of an instrument, for instance? Could be green and blue, and you want to change the color. Is in the user interface or is in the functions part? Any idea? you have your sharing app, you plot an histogram, and you want to change the color of the instrument. The bars of the instrument have to be green, and you want to put them green. Where do you have to do that? Shall we?
Arguments to the
Instagram function? In the functions. Even it looks like I'm using interface because it's the color of the graph, this is part of the function. The user interface is the position that you want to put in your page, or if you want to show the value that you want to choose, show to the user from 1 to 15, and by default 5, and you want to put 7. This is something useful, it's part of the user interface. But the inner properties of the graphs, you have to change this in the function. So the tutorial in the web page of Shanghai's will do it. It's you want to do that, just follow the structure because they're fine. I think this is to get the overview of how you have to structure your documentation. You have to get aware of these two parts. The easiest way to do that, and then to apply, is go to Shiny Studio, look for one of the examples that is similar to the result that they're going to obtain. Download it and edit it, rather than starting from scratch. Because it's not so difficult, but this is it. So most of there are huge amount of examples that we know, screen, update, edit the function to do necessities of what you want to achieve it, to show. So my recommendation is so, for finishing today, or this part, these are some of the references that I use for this presentation, where I was learning now. Most of them, you put there for the scenario might be a state of the art. And these ones appear in a stream or series that is R for humanities and social science. So these books are focusing on using R for text mining and text analysis tasks. This is more focusing on corpus linguistics, so the notions of corpus is introduced, how to handle a corpus in R, several libraries that are going to be explaining. If I can, for instance, one of the main reference in a virtual corpus that you are doing stuff in the memory of R, or a permanent corpus where you are sending that in a file. This is introduced also for well, I showed you at the beginning, so you want to plot your position, your radical positions. This sometimes is useful in some studies of the use of language, so you can plot about the variations of language in different communities. So, according to the geographical position. But, this one is more more statistic. Looking for frequencies, how to calculate them, how to put frequency across from text. This is more the linguistics and semantic analysis, grammar, parsing, organizations, all of that. This is more how to do frequencies of words, but then the statistical analysis of words. And this is more linguistics. And this one is, I discovered recently, is a library that was, is available for us. That implement different tools or different steps or different options that you can do in a bit. I think it's quite good. I didn't bring that too much, but it's quite good. But in text mining, and the good thing is there is a book explaining everything, that is also this web page, so it's really easy to follow, it's free. And you can see with a lot of examples, including three cases studies, and you can see how you can play with the things in R. I think it's a good one. I didn't explore too much yet, but it looks promising. As I told you yesterday, these days I'm trying to play with more libraries and to show you the different results that you can get. But I found several problems from studying them because some of them are for fault and previous versions of R, that are not updated to one, you need to go on additional files, but sometimes you need to go to five, and they can add, can install the package when you need an additional one. Usually by default, R is installing everything you need, but not always. So, in my experience on that, installing the library was quite demanding. It's a very more difficult than that. But this is quite new, recent, so shouldn't be a problem. Any question, comment, idea? Okay. So, now I'm going to show you some examples of SMI. You have that on your computer if you want to tell it about. I will focus on basic tasks on mining or of MP that might be used for helping mining. As I told you, you can do a lot of things, you have a lot of opportunities for that because there are a few things for mining. And for me, it's interesting is these things to show the steps of the cameras. So, one of the first things that I have to tell you when I'm trying to finish up the first steps is clean your data. And this is important for not just for us, but usually. I start to play myself or to plan to get some sense of the results using the books that I'm good at private. I think most of people know that. Is the element from the data, you have a huge database with books that are free. You can download the books in a bunch of different formats, PDF, EPUB, Google as well, text, plain text, Word, everything. is available, you can download it and start to do it. The question is that these files use a lot of metadata. Okay, you want to do analysis of an object. You have to be aware about that, because most of this metadata is not relevant. Might vary your results, because it's got the right assignment, it's what you've got, there's information, but it's not in the book. It's in the file that you don't know. So you have to do this process. So this requires a bit of, if you want to, you have to do a first step, trying to identify where this metadata might be, and look for a way to remove that. So, I use the Moby Dick book, which is some of these examples. So, I get the knowledge from the project. There is a library now that you can directly connect other project with them. So, you don't need to download the file. You can directly access to that. But it's not a huge task, but if you are working with several books, it's easier. So you have, I download the book, and the first step is so here I have the nominal file. The first step, the decision of the necessary. As I told you, you have to make a decision here which data type I want. In this case I choose a vector. Any idea what? The question that I have to keep in my mind to make this decision. So the first one is what I want, what I need. If I need the number divided by chapters, it might be worth to create a list. And each one of the components of the list is a chapter. So if I want to get the compare, make comparison between the different the use of a word between chapters is easier because I have all of them in my list because I can compare them. If I want to do just a global analysis of the novel, it's not worth to create a list because for applying an operation, you have to apply in all of the components of. If you put all of them in a vector, it's much easier. More or less? So the first step. So this is what I mentioned before. Here we are using the span function for reading the lines. remind me, this is the regular expression for fake lands. This is not, so I'm reading the book as it appears in the document, which land is a common vector. And here I'm showing the first part, the first six components that I have in the vector with here. And as you can see, in good morning, what the web, I have a memory, you know what I mean? This is all the memory that I want to know. So, how can I remove this metadata? Any idea? How do you want to look for the way that I address this is this maybe naive, but it works. So, I know that the novel is starting with the chapter 1. Everything that is before chapter 1, I don't care. I don't need the English, I don't need the information about the book, I just need the chapter 1. So, how can I do that? I have everything I'm working. Yes, look. For chapter 1 in my lecture. There is something that you have to be aware of here. That each line of the book is a component of the is an element in the book. If I write in here just chapter 1 without numbers, this is chapter 1 and quotation marks, the quiz function that is for looking for information on vector. This works or not? What do you think? If I want to ask chapter 1, I don't care what this quotation marks, does it work or not? Yes? No? Maybe? Who thinks that this works? Just writing the first part of the component of the element of the letter is enough. It doesn't work. Why? Because when you are looking in a vector now, just using this without the regular expression at the end, you are looking for the exact component. So if the element here, the component of the vector, is chapter 1 lumens, and you just into chapter 1 without finishing with the regular expression that I will cover this. After that, it wouldn't work because you're looking for the exact content of the letter. Okay? For finding the last, when the book finish, just go to the file and look what is the last line. In this case, it is open. So, what I'm doing here. Given that I have all the components in a vector, I am getting the number of the component, the number, the index, sorry, the index that appears in the vector. So, chapter 1 is in the index that I need. It's here, so here, I'm saying nothing from start, and the last. Index and in last, so the way to do that after that, I know which is the index of the first line of the book, the index of the last line of the book. Just copying that and saving that, I have the book. You don't need to do anything else. this is a complex way of, more complex way than that, because you know, I was saying here is saying the metadata into another vectors. So for that reason, that, but you are just interested in the numbers of that. And I set in a new vector that number lines that is here all the lines of now let's think of the one that I want to plot is you have this image in the book, so you have to start to make decisions according to the example you want to obtain. So according to the decision you have to be aware about the type and try to look for the exact information and the problem that might appear. Here was the, as I told you, metadata, I want to remove it. So here, here is a book, you know the file, it's a book, maybe you have a million of documents, might be more difficult to do that. But you might think another strategy, but according to that, you have to define the different steps. Ah, something important that I told you yet is you have to be aware about the definition and implement functions to change that. So if you are using the files in a different codification, you might read this strange stuff. So be aware of that. But it's quite easy to solve because R will implement functions to do that. So you can modify the way. So this is coming in now. Here, it for the thing that I want to do now is tokenization, tokenize all the another. But there are something that I'm not interested in to analyze in this way that are the titles of the chapters. So how can I remove the titles of the chapter? It's easy. I have all the lines in the vector in now. So I look for this regular expression. Now I have to make this easier. I have to look. I know that all the chapters are the chapter. So I'm looking for chapter capital letters. Can you see the difference between this looking for this pattern and the previous one? The previous one and the other was chapter one. It was exact. It was looking for this exact string. But here, I have an illustration of that. I say chapter, I don't care what is after chapter. I just look at this pattern in this vector. This is what it means. So here, what is this? What do you think what these numbers mean? Why I don't have chapter 1, chapter 2, and chapter 3? Why I have these numbers? What does they mean? These are the index where the chapter is what appears. My topic here is, okay, I have this vector. Tell me where all this pattern in what components of the vector appear. I have the index here, and the next step is to say, okay, to the vector that I have, remove the index here, square brackets, remove all these lines. And that, that was why I am a huge fan of that. In two lines, I think I was able to remove this intervention I would want without having to create a fork, without having to create anything else. If this happens, check the next line. For me, as a background developer, this is much easier to think and to understand and to have in my mind the steps that I have to follow. I don't have to be aware of this level. It was a four, so I have this structure, I have to go line by line and check the patterns here or not. If it's here, I say the index. Next one, if I appear that or that. No, yes. Another expression. Another one. More or less. So, the next thing that to tokenize. So, sometimes, as I told you before, you have your vector now, you can paste and combine everything in a single line, in a vector of dimension one. So, until now, what I had was all the words per line, the number per line, with quotation mark, with everything there. Sometimes as we work to get all the work that we want to do analysis of, manual depending on the task, and we want to have all of them in a single vector, because it's easy to a vector of dimension one, because it's easier to apply things. This is I need this step because after that I can split the whole novel into words, not the line, and remove all the information that I'm not interested in a really simple step. That is using the regular expression for any character written to a word or letter as a breakpoint. So automatically, using that, the problem is here. As I told you, you don't need to create a form, you need something that is now is collapsed, you match everything into a vector of dimension one, and string a split using everything that is not a word. That's great. So you get all the words split, the new vector, which, well, each component of the vector is a word. This is an easy way to calculate the number of words of the novel. If you get the length of the vector, it's done. So, are you getting there? I want to show you the idea how to think this problem in MLP, and in R, with the functions that we have, to get the result that we're looking for. You don't have to look for small steps. If you need words, if you need lines, if you want to remove punctuations, no. Chapters, more or less. So now I'm going there's another idea that I was playing with that. That is talking answer. This is the one that they call under the start, this is love. What I meant about this feeling any problem with that, but to install libraries in us what we need to just install packages in the name, in quotation marks. This is important. You have to put this at the beginning to use that. Once we install, we have to say, well, I'm going to use this library. And this here. So, this library makes our life even easier. Because, for instance, to get the number of the right into sentences, not by lines. You want, for instance, if you have to something about that in mind, it might be worth to have the sentences. Sentences, or to analysis, or to analysis, or you want to compare that with the similarity. So it might be worth it. In R, it shouldn't be so difficult to do. You have to use that organization to get there and using the points at the breaks. But with these libraries, other libraries will be easier. Yes. One is I have the number in a vector, this one. I tokenize with this library, and I get the sentence. What is the output? What is the data type of the output of this function? It's a vector, a vector frame, a list, a matrix. I don't have to do more about that, but this is the output is a list. It's not a vector. So, as I told you yesterday several times, you have to be aware about the output of the function. If you are using that, and depending on the next step that you want to do, you might have to do that. So, here, the next step that I want to do is to put all the words in our cases. So there's a maximum amount of that to go over. But I can apply this function to a list. Because of the top of the list is how it's structured. You can apply the function that will be all the components of the list. You should have will be more complex to the lab. Here, there's a list, you are obtaining a vector from this list. So it's much easier to manipulate using a selector of the map. Remind this is important. Be aware about the output of the function that you use to put the value on that. The next step that you have to do will be read. Okay? Other thing that you can do, as I did before in all of the previous steps, is to get the words of the number. But here, with this library, we have object in that to get the word just in different I have a novel, upon novel, as I told you, for lines, in this person. Tokenized words, and here I'm trying the words. Again, this is a list. I want a vector, and this is a string. You create on this function, and the number. And you are getting the results of the map without computation map, without anything. So there are tools here to do that, that makes our life easier as a project for us. Our life programs for science. We want to make things happy. Without and to get the length of the number, modeling has 200,000, more than 200,000 words. Just to check that I everything in the right way. For instance, here another function of this library combination, you can get just the number 4. And you can see here the result is the same. More or less, okay, so this is an example. So there are a lot of them opening the key. This is the official one, most of the packages of R. This one. Here you have a description of a bunch of them, open in a key, that is very popular, typing text, that is the one that we did before. That's a super project. Also, this one, there is an interface to work map. Another that is very popular is the corpus. Here. But it's a bit difficult to install. This one, this one type of structure. But they are huge amount of them. Tools that you can use. Done. Also more web pages, a lot of information. This is also interesting. It's a text mining framework that includes a bunch of different options just specifically for text mining with the option that they are incorporating for Quora, which is now. And you can make the good thing here is you can annotate this data as well, so you can get annotated data using R. I never tried this, but I think it's possible obtaining JSON readable file to show graphically when you have this data. This is a pending task that I have to address. I think that should be possible. And the other way around, you can read the JSON file in R, basically. It's easier from a CSV. But the good thing of R, my opinion as well, is the translation to another format. So R can read quite well different files and get the content to the program. So this document of information. The library that I mentioned before, this is the rule that you have done. But everything is free available in this page. As I told you, the case studies, everything will recommend the name, fancy graphs, basically, instead. So it looks compromising. I didn't play with that enough. But it looks really good. Also something interesting is it implements both for engrams and correlations. So it's, this is a quite popular for text money kind of stuff. And run, so my reward, my reward for that. As I told you, there's a bunch of options that you can do. Honestly, then, the important idea that I want to emphasize when working these steps, well, you know, be aware about the data type that you're using and the output of the functions that you apply. Otherwise, the result that you are looking for will be different than you can have. From my experience, when I was teaching art for a couple of years, as students with different backgrounds, they struggled with this. They made mistakes when they were learning and things with the functions and the output that you obtained. Okay. Now I told you, I'm telling you, ah, we were about this, and you said, yeah, well, but when you are doing, sometimes it's difficult to remind, and keep in mind that this might be a source of mistakes that you have in your career. The last thing that I know, that I want to show you is with that, in addition to plot bar plots, line graphs, pie charts, you also can run graphs. For argumentation is quite important. One of the most useful and common ways of showing an argument is using a graph. So we can draw a graph using our square. The library is, the package is a graph. And the very basic ones are under graphs, so we have the others to draw. And the way of showing that is using this function, graph formula. So this is the the node origin and the node target, and you have to connect them with two lines. In the case of the case of a graph, it has to be a class. The good thing of this library from graph formula is that it can read different data type. Here is a vector that if you have a data frame, it can be able to square. So depending on the component that you have in the data frame, you can obtain really nice graphs. As the other graphs and the other properties are shown, there is a bunch of options you can customize. And you can be changing that, changing the colors, changing the label, labeling that, the type of letter, the size of the edge, the size of the nodes. And this is the last stop, the last thing that you have to remember is you have to plot that. It's a plot function. This is the object that you are saying. This is the type of this is the type of node. This is how we are described. And this is important. This requires to make every single time that the distribution of the nodes is the same. It's not changing because every time that you are generating the graph, it might change. So, you can have a result
ideas to the reserves of time. This is the day of that. You have the notes. Imagine that you have, instead of node 1 and node 2, you have the components of the argument that you want to present, or the arguments, and you are saying that in the local frame, you have everything put there in the right way, generating the visual representation is a simple step. This is, as I told you, one of the strengths of R, that is plotting these things as ways. So having this and playing with that is really, really interesting. This is the function to generate the graph from a frame, so it's called. And the last important thing that we need to mention about this library is you can apply, if you have your data well structured in a data frame, you can use this data frame to calculate one of the graph metrics that we have. These are implemented in the library. So again, if you have your data frame well structured and you plot for the parameters and all that, generating a lot of metrics, information that the algorithms allow us is an easy task. Just to conclude, and this is how you plot that in a line. This week is offices. Yeah, I want to tell you, and this pattern, this is the direct graph. It shouldn't be like this. I don't know why. It's probably my ideas. Maybe I change some numbers and parameter to play. Maybe. Well, we should be a hybrid graph. So, for concluding, what I want to flag is there is a tool, R, that is useful for might be useful for argument tasks, because the processing of natural language is quite easy. There are a lot of libraries there, even sometimes are difficult to start. And R now is becoming more popular. As far as I know, I'm going to go over the notes for my name. And that's all for today. Any questions? Comment? Idea? Feel free. You can find, I guess, I'm sure you can find my email in the documentation of the course. If you have any questions, criticism as well, comment, or just feel free to email me or ask me. No? Okay, thank you very much. Bye.